Okay, we it went from a no wind at all to about a 28-30 mile an hour wind right now that came up within probably 5 minutes. And of course, by the time I got the camera set up and got over here in the car and separated, there's no way I can film outside right now. The car is shaking. You can probably hear the wind coming through the windows. But the horses were really exhibiting a lot of playful, good, communicative dominance behavior. And I was going to try to film it, and I couldn't. So I'm hoping maybe they'll start up again. And we'll talk about some herd dynamics here. But if you notice the herd, normally the horses are much more spread out. And notice the tightness of this herd. This herd has all this pasture out here, and yet every single horse that's out there is pretty much within a stone's throw of each other. Now, why is that? Well, when this wind kicked up, first of all, they started playing and pushing and doing all this dominance, but they lost their ability to hear predators. They felt unsafe. They felt less comfortable being kind of separated out. Of course, the sun's kind of like right in the camera, and no matter what I do, it's going to reflect off the windshield. So, sorry, that's just the way it is. It's the only place I can film. So, understanding when horses are in a tight pack in a herd, if the wind isn't blowing, you should ask yourself why, what's going on. Now we get a little bit of movement here. Again, this is every horse in the pasture pretty close. They can see each other. They're eating all in the same spot. Not because that's the best spot. They're hanging out, I think, with either Mr. T and that other strong gelding, and that's where they're eating. So the rest of the herd is eating there too. No horse wants to be by himself when he can't hear. He lost his ability to identify a predator. Now he can only see a predator. So his dependency on the herd is much greater in high wind, which happens when you ride your horse. People want to label it spooky. The horse is scared of the wind. There's all these. That's not true. Horses have, they're always on. I don't want to get in trouble. I don't want to find myself in a place where I can get eaten. I know I'm food. So because of that, they're always. There goes Buddy. He's chasing that little marrow. She almost kicked him in the head. He's still chasing her. And now I don't know where he's going. He's off chasing a butterfly. Remember I told you all the horses are. Oh, you know where he went? See? Made me look like a dummy. He went behind a tree and said, "It's quiet over here. I can hear." Now, because he went by the tree, what's the other herd going to do? Are they going to follow? Are they going to stay with Mr. T? It looks like there's a horse kind of leading to him. I don't know if that's Mr. T. But Buddy left the herd, and now we have another horse following him. And I can't tell if that's Mr. T. If it is, you're going to see the rest of the herd start following. There you go. See this packing up mentality? See this? I don't want to be alone in the wind because I can't hear. The wind's blowing so hard. I mean, it is stinking blowing. I don't know if you can see that tree, but believe me, it's shaking the truck. And because Buddy moved, and I don't think Buddy's high horse, but because he left the herd and went by that tree, he suckered Mr. T next to him, which brought the other horse right behind Mr. T, his girlfriend, and therefore the rest of the herd went with him. No other horses over here. They were all eating over here. They're not there anymore. They all moved because of one horse, Buddy, causing problems. So now, I don't know if that's Mr. T. I think that is Mr. T. Him and Buddy got behind that tree and said, "We want out of the wind." Now, I hear a lot that horses are so stupid they won't even go in shelter when it rains. And I've talked about this in other videos. Buddy and Mr. T are in a compromised position right now to detect predators. They are blinded by this tree. So they're making a decision to have comfort out of the wind. Maybe they can see better. Maybe they can hear better because the wind isn't there, but they lost their ability to scan the whole area. Now they've lost their ability to see as much as these other horses can see that are out here. These horses aren't going to go by the tree. Now, why? Maybe because it's too crowded. Maybe because they're lower. Maybe because they feel more comfortable out here. All kind of reasons on why this little sub herd to the left here didn't go with the other herd by the tree. And again, this to me, this isn't rocket science. I mean, people want to make horses a lot more complicated. I mean, if you just think like a horse and kind of figure out that, hey, I don't want to get eaten. And it's no different than you going into a horrible neighborhood, the worst neighborhood you could think of. If you're from the East Coast, somewhere in New York, maybe, I guess, or Florida, and if you're over here, maybe somewhere down in Los Angeles or Oakland or somewhere, to where it's the worst neighborhood that you can think of. If you went in there with 50 cops surrounding you, your behavior would be a lot different than if you got dropped off by a taxi in the middle of the night in this neighborhood and felt really uncomfortable and alone. You would be looking for that friendly face. You would be looking for that cop. You would be looking for that light. You'd be looking for shelter that you felt safe that you go to. You wouldn't probably feel comfortable just hanging out in the street. Well, horses aren't no different. They just find comfort and discomfort in different ways. They find comfort in open areas where they can see and hear. They find comfort in herds to where they know that there's other horses that can protect them because there's safety in numbers. And the other horses will warn them by throwing their head up, by running and stomping their feet. And when they run, they feel those hoof marks on the ground and it causes a vibration and that alerts them. So even if they got their butt to another horse, if that horse runs off, they can feel the vibration. They can hear the hooves. All those big, flashy, quick movements are warning the horses. That's why when you're working with a horse, you need to be aware of your body. You don't know what signals you're sending. You don't know the minute cues that you do that are telling the horse something that you have no clue that what you just told the horse. You have no idea with the horse. That's why the horse can't be wrong, because the horse perceives things from his world. And when you do something and a horse reacts and you go, stupid horse, that shows your inability to say, the horse is just being a horse. I need to learn what I did to cause the horse to do that. I need to know why that horse reacted that way to what I did. What is the horse feeling? What's he thinking? What does he believe? Then you can approach it from the horse's perspective. How can I get him to understand? How can I build trust? How can I change my behavior so I don't make the horse feel uncomfortable? So I don't make my horse flinch. Now, with this wind here, another thing I want to talk about was riding in the wind. These same things happen when you work your horse in the wind. They lose their ability to hear. So when you're walking your horse into the wind, not only are you taking away his hearing because he's going to point his ears back and tuck them down so dirt and bugs and everything don't fly in his ears, but he's also going to lose his sight, because the wind is going to dry out his eyes and he's not going to be able to look forward. He'll be blinking more and there may be dust and dirt being blown in his eyes. So now you've kind of created his anxiety and stress even more by walking your horse into the wind. Same way if you ride in the rain. When I'm riding in the rain, especially when I'm riding in sideways rain, and when I walk my horse into the rain, I duck my head. I keep my hat bill over my eyes and I try to keep the wind and rain out of my face. Well, a horse can't do that. So when I put a horse into the rain, I have to realize I'm taking away his ability to put his ears up because he don't want water in it. He's not putting his eyes straight in wind because the raindrops hurts his eyes. He ain't got sunglasses. He don't have a bill that can protect him. But I see people walking their horse in the rain, and when a horse gets uncomfortable, he starts getting head throwy, he starts trying to work sideways, he doesn't want to go. They want to make it into stubborn horse. Stupid horse don't listen. I need to get bigger spurs. I need to tie a knot. I need to get a bigger whip. What you need to do is stop and understand why the horse is doing what it's doing from the horse's point of view. See, to us, to humans, we have so many luxuries. You know, we've got shoes on our feet, so when we walk over rocks, we think a horse should be able to walk over rocks. When we have a hat on in the sun, we don't get sunburn or sun glare on our eyes because we have sunglasses and hats. Horses don't do that, so they get sunburn, they get glare, they get that reflection, they get the heat. Okay, we can shoe a fly with our hands and brush it off and put things around us to keep the flies off. A horse only has his tail. So when somebody braids a tail and takes that ability away, they hurt the horse. That's when flies land on the eyes. That's when they cause infections, because the horse can't get the flies off of those areas. So the horse allows the flies to lay eggs, to eat, to bite, to become festered. And then we want to say, why does my horse do this? Well, because you're braiding a tail, or because you're wrapping the tail, or because, you know, I mean, there's no right or wrong. And another guy who was, I communicate with about different people, there's not really a right or wrong in horsemanship, people. To me, if it's right by the horse, then it's right. And there's a lot of ways to be right by the horse. And sometimes you have to choose between what's some way right and what's big right, and what's really important and what isn't. And if you think like a horse and you understand a horse, you would realize that what's important to a horse is other horses, being in the open, not having shoes to where his feet hurt, not having a bit in their mouth, not having their tail braided, being able to either graze or eat hay that was spread out and not necessarily just fed on dirt to where they have to eat the dirt and they pick through their alfalfa, or breaking up a bale of alfalfa instead of throwing it like a brick and making the horse chew big hunks, taking the time to shake it apart, separate the stems, make a nice grass pile so the horse can eat more naturally. Those are things, to me, if I was a horse, that I would appreciate. Having a good, clean source of water. If you're going to fence me up, then at least give me clean water. If you're going to let me roam, then I'll go find the water I want. But if you just give me crap water that you're too lazy to clean or dump or clean the algae out or wash the bucket, and it just sits there and it ferments, and you put fish in there to pee and poop in the water bucket because you're too lazy to clean it, and you think the fish are keeping it clean, and then I have to drink all this bacteria crap, that, to me, that's not what a horse would want. So I guess when the wind blew up, I really wanted to get these guys rearing, because these horses were pushing, lower horses were pushing, lower horses and high horses were pushing lower and higher, and there was a lot of challenging, and there was a lot of good bucking and running and just horses being horses. And I missed all that, and then as soon as I got this video out, of course, it calmed down, and now we just got a bunch of horses. So anyway, again, the wind, big factor to the horse in a lot more ways than us. A human will see the wind as, my horse is scary, he's more dangerous, I don't want to ride him, I want to avoid it. A horse sees the wind as, it's the wind. It's not like it's bad or good weather to a horse. A horse doesn't think, darn, the wind's blowing today, it's going to be a bad day. They just are. They're with their environment, and they are. When it rains, it rains. When it's cold, it's cold, and when it's hot, it's hot. So a horse doesn't see the wind as a bad thing. Humans label it bad. You know, there's an old saying that news is just news. People put a label whether it's good news or bad news. Because I can tell 10 people something and 5 may think that's good and 5 others may not think it's good. But what I said is still the same. So news is news. To a horse, survival is survival. And if the wind's blowing, well, then I adapt and I adjust. And I try to live within the wind. And I may find a tree to hide behind, or I may choose to stand out in the open. I may choose to have my butt to the wind. I may choose to graze into the wind so I can see. All these decisions are made by horses, and it's made because of their past experiences, because of their herd dynamics. All these horses would be doing something different if you took a few horses out. If any of these horses were alone, none of these horses would be where they're at. The whole thing would change. This horse, I guarantee you, would not be standing out in the middle of this pasture if she was by herself. She wouldn't do it. She feels comfortable. She has horses here for warning. She has horses here for warning. So she feels comfortable being right there. This horse is facing the wind. He's facing into the wind, so his hearing is not as good. Look at his tail. It's moving away from his body. It's not going under his body. This horse has his butt to the wind. Look at his tail. It's going under the body. So he can hear better, but he can't see behind him. But you know what? He can smell behind him. Because the way his tail is blowing, he's smelling all the horses behind him. If those horses move and he stops smelling them, he will probably change his position. Because all these horses are using all their senses to feel safe. their nose what they smell, their ears what they hear, their feelings on whether a horse is running, the vibration in the ground. All these things are being affected, or being, I guess, computed in a horse's mind on where I want to stand, how I want to stand, and what I want to do. And the only thing that changes when you ride your horse in the wind is you throw in multiple factors. You throw in the saddle. You throw in if the pad doesn't fit and it causes pressure. You throw in if there's dirt under the saddle because you didn't brush them. You throw in if you accidentally spur them when you get on them, or you spur them when you get scared. You throw in because you're nervous and it's windy and you're afraid to get bucked, so your seat tightens up and your legs tighten up and your arms tighten up and the bit gets tighter and your reins are tighter because you're nervous of the wind and you know that you have to control your horse because in the wind the horse does something crazy. So understanding how all these factors just interfere with the horse's ability. Now you throw a bit in there to where it's painful, and now the horse is dealing with pain from the spurs, from the bit, from the rider pulling, from the rider giving conflicted cues, from the rider not understanding that the wind is in the horse's eyes and ears and there's dust, and the rider doesn't understand any of the thing that the horse is feeling, or doesn't question, why is my horse doing what it's doing? That's when you get into problems. That's when you get show 'em who's boss. That's when you get hard bits, hard hands, hard spurs, bigger spurs. That's when you have problems with horses. I guarantee you, when you see people hurt in the wind, it's riders that do not understand their horse most of the time. Now, you know, I could get hurt in the wind. I get out here and a big old tarp fly by. My hat just flew off when I was messing with Buddy and Tanner, and I had Tanner, and when it flew off, both horses freaked out because they weren't expecting it. They both know a hat flies off, but the wind was so strong and had them so jacked up, and the horses were running, and there was all these other factors going on, and my hat flies off, and I'm like, crap, right at a gate. So I'm at a choke point. We're trying to get him through a gate. I only have a lead rope on Mr. T, and Buddy rears out of the way of the hat. When he rears, Mr. T rears back away from him. He goes to the end of the lead rope. I'm in the middle of the gate. There's horses that are coming out, and all these things happen. And you know what? It is what it is. I said, it's all right. I got a hold of Mr. T. I hung on a rope. Mr. T came on in. Buddy came in after saw Mr. T. My hat blew away, and we went and we got in the pasture. So again, all that could have changed had I tried to save my hat, had I suddenly started trying to correct Buddy because he reared and he caught Mr. T to rear. That stupid horse could have got me killed, and then I started chewing out both horses, and I start... That's what happens when there's problems with horses. Remember, in the wind, horses can't hear as well, they can't see as well. Their natural anxiety and stress and fear and alertness all moves up. When that happens, you need to be aware on what you do. You need to become quieter. You need to become more confident. You need to become clearer. You need to expect the unexpected. You need to be ready for when a horse does something and say, you know what? I knew that was probably going to happen. When you start knowing what's going to happen before it happens, your reaction is less. When your reaction is less, the horse reads that as confidence. He reads that as calmness. Therefore, he can relax. Therefore, he will come to you and look to you for leadership, and know that you're strong, and know that you're not fear, and notice that you're not jerking. When you react, yank, pull, scream, crazy horse, stupid horse, pull, try to correct him, that's when you jack the horse up. A horse is a reflection of you. So I really want people to understand horses, and I want them to look at horses differently when they see other people with horses. Because when you see a horse getting yanked in the mouth with a bit, and rearing, and being uncontrollable, and people chasing them, and people talking about how crazy their horse is, and how the horse didn't have oxygen, and how the horse was fed bad hay, and how the horses had too much grain or not enough grain, or how the horse is mentally challenged, or whatever else they want to come up with, I want you to be able to understand, you know what? That's just a horse, and he's being a horse. And what he did is totally 100% explainable and understandable, because I understand horses. When you can get there, you're good to go. This herd's kind of threading out a little bit. These guys are moving. These two horses over here are kind of staying here. So we have these two horses here, have their butt to the wind. We have Mr. T and Buddy by the tree, blocking the wind, relaxing. And we have these horses over here. Now, another factor that I didn't, I'm at 19 minutes, I gotta get off here. Another factor I didn't prevent, why is Buddy and Mr. T by this tree relaxing and standing in there? They just got fed. They got full bellies. They got hay. They don't need food right now because they're full. Guess what? These other horses weren't fed. They were let out pasture. So what? Guess what? They're on a mission. They're on a mission to feed their belly. It takes a lot of little pieces of grass to keep up 1,100 pounds. So they're out there saying, you know what? The wind's blowing, and I don't necessarily want to be out here, but I got to eat. I got to survive. So therefore, they're going to eat. So they're grazing because it's needed and it's required. These guys are grazing over here, and Mr. T and Buddy are living a good spoiled life. Just got their fat butts fed, and now they're over there saying, we're going to take a nap in this nice breezy day when the sun's out in the comfort protected by this tree. All right, little herd behavior. Hope that helps. Well, in that there, Buddy Mr. T, all you horses are good little boys and girls.